You're right, guys. Well, it's Calplex here. So welcome back to Calplex Rambles about his computer. How did this happen? Again, I really should have done Party Play first because it's just going to take a long time to load. We're doing the usual. That's right. The ditch. Time to pee because I've got all this time. Hopefully, I noticed my mic kept like cutting out and then my camera does this weird warm thing. I've got it set to automatic because I have no clue what I'm doing with cameras. If I set it to automatic, it should put everything right for me. So problem number one, this happened last weekend now. So wait, when was that? That was about, So the 22nd to the 23rd of May. I know this video is coming out a little bit later, but I try and get ahead when I can do because luckily this happened and I was ahead. So I managed to have a video uploaded for you all. I was using my PC fine the night before, like nothing abnormal happened. I just woke up, turned on my PC for the day, got like my hair, beard and everything done like I normally do. And like, it was a bit weird. I just had a load of error message popping up, like error when loading, error when loading, error when loading. And I couldn't get rid of them because each time I pressed okay, another one would pop through, another one would pop through. And it was all for different applications, like Agato, Go XLR, which is what I used to talk into this, everything. I was like, okay, I'll restart my PC because you know, when in doubt, restart your PC, it fixes it half the time. So next thing you know, it boots up actually fine after I restart, but it's still popping up with those error messages. So I was like, okay, something's not right. I did just do a software update. So I'll revert back to the old one and then try and update again in case, you know, Windows messes up. The system restore works. Perfect. Fine. Let's boot him back up. Blue screen. Okay, fine. Whatever. PCs do that. Just turn it off and turn it back on again. See if it boots back up. Blue screen. The blue screen error message I was getting was this. Critical process died. So I was like, okay, fine, I'll Google it, see what the way is to fix that. I tried every method under the book, even trying to go back to before the system restore and everything. No, it just wouldn't allow it. System run, a system repair, didn't work. Tried booting off a USB stick into Windows repair, didn't like it. So I had one solution and I didn't like it, but I was okay with it. So I unplugged every SSD, every hard drive, everything but one, which was my boot drive, from my computer, and then reinstalled Windows again. Every program, every system software, settings, everything gone. But annoyingly, as I was doing that, but also, like, annoyingly, but not so annoyingly, actually. Why would I say annoyingly? Because that's not annoyingly. It then was like, okay, yeah, I see where you got Windows already installed. We'll run a repair. Fine. Okay. Try doing it. It failed and was like, oh, we can't do that. We'll reinstall Windows, but we'll create a copy on the same drive called windows.old, which allowed me to keep my stuff. Thankfully, I was like, you know what? Screw it. just do it. Just install, create the windows.old, which luckily I had only like 2 gigabytes left on my install drive after Windows reinstalled itself and kept all my old data. I was like, okay, don't worry about it. Booted in, clean Windows, went into my old folder, and luckily everything's there. Every beautiful thing's there, like system files, everything. All I had to do was to copy them across and try not to lose them again. So I plugged everything in again, so hard drives, other SSDs and everything. They were all being seen fine. And then copied things like my backup across to a different hard drive and then copied parts over just to see how... if I can get my stuff back. I mean, I turned around the wrong direction once, but 45 for this run, not too bad. Just need a little bit more speed. But luckily able to copy all my images across, everything other than like program system stuff. Like I have my camera set in the top right-hand corner that saves as like a preset. Had to remap all that in my Vegas. Had to reinstall Vegas. That was a pain. System fonts weren't working. So do you know how if I type down below like some text, which you can see here, that wasn't working. Turns out all you have to do is right click and then go install for all users for some reason. And then that fixes it. Don't know why. Weird fix, but okay. All right. I'll bail here because then I had to get everything reinstalled, which pretty much took me 2 days to get everything set up, back up and running. So I managed to record a video and then edit it during the week. So that was my skate.park video, which I think has just gone live. Oh, it's about to go live in 10 minutes right now. So I got that all up and running and fixed a lot of shit. I was like, cool. Fix all the shit, all up and running. Forget about it. It should be fine. Mic settings, luckily, I managed to copy like my mic settings and everything because that was a pain to set up and I had to get Shasta to help me out. Because this microphone is not sensitive. This is like the least sensitive microphone in the world here. And I use a use a cloud lifter, which gives me 48 gain more than usual. And then I put it into a Go XLR, which has a lot of like a massive preamp in there. So it allows to power like this thing because I turn it into a condenser microphone. But it's then for some reason it picks up my voice, but also picks up my fan or my computer. I also, sorry if you can hear the birds outside, it probably shouldn't do that, but if you do, it's hot here. And that leads on to last week where I tried recording the Skate 2 debug menu. Should have been an easy thing, right? So I don't know what the latest NVIDIA software system update has done. So what I used to do was I used to record my desktop and then launch the application of what I wanted to record. Like Xenia, which was the last thing I used, my RCPCS3, but I keep it in like desktop mode. And then I just cut it out and zoom in a little bit because I record in 4K. It doesn't look that bad quality still. And there we go. Done. So I made a video for about an hour and 40 minutes. An hour and 40 minutes, I was just talking. I was doing this. I was playing. I was messing around with everything. I literally tested everything in that video. Then it was done. I was like, thank God. I got through all of that. It was beautiful. I had some really amazing reactions. This is my first time looking at it because I saved my moment for it. Looking at that Skate 2 debug menu. And then, yeah, just decided to record my desktop. Ignored the gameplay on the screen and recorded the desktop. The only time you saw the game is when it crashed. And it showed the one frame of it in-game when it crashed. And then it like doing that minimize thing. Yeah, cool. I've got nothing to work with here. Made my frustration. I thought, you know what? No worries. My reactions won't be as raw, but I'll re-record it. I probably missed some stuff here and there because I know some stuff crashed from there. I was like, okay, I'll try that again and it crashed. So I was like, okay, whatever. So I skipped some stuff and done the video. I waited it for it to process. Put it in Vegas. I thought, you know what? I'm not using Shadowplay. I'm going to use OBS to record my screen. Stuck at 1080p. But the game wasn't at 4K anyway. Like right now, I'm using Shadowplay again because I tested it and it worked. Skate 3 hopefully should record in 4K. But the emulator which I was using wasn't in 4K and then in 1080p, and I didn't want to go through all that stress again. Anyway, this time everything worked again. Recording, fine gameplay, gorgeous. Love it. You know what gave up this time? Yeah, that's right. You already know. My camera. Actually, I tell a lie. It wasn't my camera's fault. Because my camera recorded, Elgato decided to record just black. I could see my camera, like right now, I'm looking at my camera and I can see me. This is just like, I have it here just to make sure I know what's up. If there's anything which is causing like bugs or anything which I can see straight away, I'd go to it. Luckily, audio was fine. Everything was fine. And I contemplated, that's when I tweeted, and I was contemplating like, I'm just going to not lose my face cam for this. A minute later, I decided I want my face cam in it. I don't know, with that type of video, if it was just a talking type video, I could do like a Cypress and whatever, and just as it is now, and just survive without a face cam. But because it was so like reaction based and everything, I wanted my face in there. So I was like, ah. So I re-recorded again. I fixed it by just moving my drive to what I'm recording to a different drive, which is fine. Has enough space on it. Recorded the video and luckily it all came out again. There's always a but. There's always a but. And there's one right there. P3's got flat butts. My face cam cut out halfway through. It just stopped recording my face. I was like, okay, it's done this before. Why? Why would you do this? There's no point. Okay, whatever. Luckily, it was mostly towards the end of the video. Oh, I wasn't too upset and there wasn't much reaction lost. I was like, you know what? After everything that's worked, don't care editing this. So I spent about 6 hours recording that one video. Like, it was just like, I was so looking forward to it because I saw this thing and I completely forgot about this dev build for Skate 2. I thought, that's amazing. Why hasn't anyone made a video on this yet? Well, other than GHFear and the guy who showcased it. And I saved my reaction as well. Oh my God. I saved so much time just like wanting to do it. And I just like, no, I don't want to spoil it. Life spoils it in general, really. I'm not too sure what's going on with this PC, man. Like nothing's going on like terrible with it. Like it's not a bad PC. It does like it's decent compared to most. Don't get me wrong. I would love to upgrade the graphics cards, but you know what's happening right now. And if you don't, just don't. So with the emulators, I was actually quite lucky other than my Skate 2 and Skate 1 emulator, because for some reason I had that saved on my C drive. But my Skate 3 one, which just has all this modding stuff done to it, I was so, so lucky. So everything normally is stored on the C drive of your computer, which is where Windows is installed on. But I had my emulators installed on a separate SSD, which is fine because when I installed everything, so the correct like drivers, the correct like Visual C++ program, which was required for this to run, and booted it back up, everything was working. All like my textures, which I modded in, like my rainbow and everything. I thought I was gonna have to redo them again, which is fine. Would have been fine to be honest, but just not having to do that again just saved so much time. And I just booted up, loaded. It took as long as it normally did, but hey, modded textures. Who cares? What is it with me at the dish today getting these 40s? All right, 50 hopefully coming in soon. That is my target. I would love to get 50 at the dish. Love to. The Rainbow Grip play, still here, still alive. But yeah, that was pretty much it for this week's video. It's a lot shorter than my other ones. I've been recently pushing out like a lot more like longer videos, which I hope you guys enjoyed. I ruined this run. hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope you guys enjoyed me rambling on about my PC problems again and again. I swear, I work in computers as well, man. Come on. It was just like what I need after a full week of working with computers is fixing my computer. Thank you for watching. Hope you guys have a good rest of your day and a week. And as always, do the outro.